give us a good audio sync. And we'll go take a little ride. We got some new pavement. Just put out one of my favorite places. See if this old girl will start. Oh, man, put gas in it. We could do that. Unless you're maybe off, I don't know. Yeah, gotta turn the ignition off. The seat button won't push. Left the bike out last night, which I never do. And it's got hands all over it. I saw Itchy Boots do a gas stop, and she only showed pulling her gas cap off and then driving away. I thought that was pretty cute. Why bore them with pouring gas and thing, right? I should be so smart. I don't pull in there as far as kind of downhill. Pushing it out of there. Oops. Kickstand, first gear. Get the hell out of here. Before you get too hot. It's 91 degrees out there. At 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Let's go up by the lake and go to the VFW road, which is the south exit to the park. And I'll show you the new paper. It's only 2 miles, but it's 2 miles of rough roads, you know, it was. And somebody came and paved that over. They did a real great job. It was a state highway perfection type job. Doesn't have any stripes. Stripes or yellow lines or anything on her right now. Maybe they'll eventually do that. But it's just nice to have it, you know. I don't use it. I would use it if they would pave it all the way to the pew. It would be an alternate route than getting up on Highway 66 and going that way, which is a little scary for a bike that goes 50 miles an hour on a good day. I know I've had it 65 with a big wind in my back. I think that's about the fast that this thing's ever gone. And me, I'm just real comfortable at 45 miles an hour, you know. Even more comfortable at 35. Okay, this is where they put the new pavement. Starts right there and heads out that way. And we're gonna take a little run on it. I'm gonna show you the burn cross at the end of the pavement. Notice all the homes, or ranches, or whatever they're called, the homes, where the pavement is and how spiffy the houses are. And then we get to this last home. We'll talk about it when we get there. This road just dangerous as hell because everybody drives down the middle of it. Because they're not used to seeing anybody on it. Kind of one of those country roads where if you ever hear about an accident, it's a head on. And everybody dies because they meet up on one of these hills. And boom! So I'll try to remember the stay to the right. Then you can walk into some guy's tractor that's wider than the road with some implement on it. Get an implement up the nose. Yeah, see how smooth this is? This road used to be terrible. This is nice. I'm doing about 35. We have a little bit of wind today, about 6 miles an hour. Southwest, it would be left or right. Don't even feel it. This is the good road we had when they replaced this bridge right here. But they only gave us a little run, and now they've connected it on both ends. And we ended up with, I gauged it yesterday on my speedometer, and it's exactly 2 miles. Now that doesn't sound like much to you guys, but sometimes I just want to go test the bike a little bit. And, get up to full speed, or relatively close, 75% cruise speed kind of thing, like you do on an airplane. So, ooh. Yeah, there's one coming over the top. And I never saw it coming. All those places are pretty nice. Then you come up here to the end of the pavement, which is right here. And look at what you got. I mean, here's a guy that works for us, you know. And there's his spread. Nobody behind me. And it's a working man's place, you know. He's got projects going on and shit. So I got friends out there living with him. But that's where they decided to end the pavement. I'd be pissed off if I was him. Yeah, if you took that road right there on up the way for about 5 miles, we'd get you to our oil royalty stuff. But if I went down that road, I'd get my bike dirty and I don't like to do that. son calls that roller coaster road. Bottomed out both of my shocks. Thought I'd flatten my tires, bent my rims, felt so bad. But, no apparent damage. I haven't checked the air on the tires yet. These tubeless tires can break out a little air once in a while if you push them up against the rim. But I haven't noticed that where I noticed it is when I'm going down the ramp at the house. And if the kickstand mount interferes too much with the
Mm-hmm.